This project is collaboration between two schools in USM, which is School of Computer Sciences and School of Industrial Technology. Hazard identification, risk assessment and risk control, also known as HIREC. HIREC is one of the main subcategory of OSHA. The aim of HIREC is to identify any factor that may cause harm in the workplace, then provide preventive measures and control it. In USM, we have UKKPU, also known as Unit Keselamatan dan Kesihatan Pekerja, who handle the issue regarding the HIREC and OSH in the campus. The problem statement for this project is, current practice that are available in USM is manual reporting and tracking, which is difficult to monitor this issue. This makes the hazard identification is difficult to conduct in the campus. This is the where the campus safe system come in. Campus safe is the system built to digitalize, provide automation and added value to the manual UKKPU business process. For the campus safe project, there are three system objectives. Firstly, to provide a portal system for the university community to identify hazard in the campus. Second, to enable campus community, which is UKKPU, to assess the risk, to suggest the control measure, and limit the impact to university community. Third, to allow the administrator to produce and gain useful insight based on the tagging that have been generated by the system. The module of the project are as follows. The campus safe system has total 5 main modules. 3 modules were developed in previous version, which is accident reporting module, accident investigation module, and tagging and analysis module. In version 2, there are another 2 new modules were added, which is hazard checklist module and risk assessment and risk control module. For tagging and analysis module, it has been continued using it in version 2 of the system. For hazard checklist module, it is responsible for OSH representatives to conduct the hazard. The next module, risk assessment and control module. This module enabling UKKPU to assess the risk and control the risk by verifying the HIREC report that has been submitted. The last module is tagging and analysis module. This module has been updated from version 1 as 2 new modules were added in the system. This module provides statistics. This module also using RAID algorithm to generate text for labeling the report. This is the campus safe architecture diagram. The campus safe system consists of 2 platforms, which are mobile application and web application. In this system, there are 4 users that will use the system. First user is USM committee. USM committee will use the mobile app to create the accident report. For next user, OSH representative. They can use both platforms. They will use this platform to conduct hazard identification based on the HIREC guideline. The next user is PTJ. PTJ will use web application to view the HIREC report based on their school. And the last user will be UKKPU. UKKPU will use the web application to view and verify HIREC report. UKKPU also can manage user and view statistical analysis that have been generated by the system. For this project, benefit and impact that can be seen is can help UKKPU to improve work efficiency to identify, prevent and control hazard in the campus. The next benefit is automatic graphical statistics generated by the system also make the job of UKKPU much easier for analyzing the hazard in the campus. The net benefit of the system can give is automation of certain input, which make filling the form much easier and faster. This system also easily accessible by everyone when they needed. Now, let's move on to the project demo. Starting with mobile application demo, given a scenario where the OSH representative conduct the hazard identification in the lab, the first thing that user need to do is to navigate to the apps and click on login button. The next step they will do is create a HIREC report. So they must click on HIREC report button and fill the general information in the form. After they fill in the general information, click on the next button. Here where the hazard identification begins. In this section, user need to fill all the details. Then click on next button. Now, here is risk assessment section where the risks are calculated based on what user input for likelihood and severity. Risk level will automatically assign based on the risk value. After that, click on next button. The next section is recommended control measure. In this section, user need to enter their recommended control measure for UKKPU to review and verify it. After complete, click on next button. Here are the last part of the form, which is user can upload an image. To upload an image, user need to click on choose image button. Then select the image from their gallery. After that, submit the report. So now the report has been submitted. Here are some additional features that can be done on the app by navigating to the site navigation on top left of the apps. As we can see on site navigation, there are hierarchy report lists. In hierarchy report list, user can see all the reports that have been verified by UKKPU. To see the detail of the report, user can click on the report and detail of the report will be displayed. In this app also, user can view and update their profile by go to the profile page on the site navigation. Now, with the mobile application done, let's move on to the web application. Now, on the web application, this tool is used by UKPU to view and verify hierarchy report. First, they need to log into the system, then they will go to the dashboard. On the dashboard, there are several charts. Before we go deeper on the chart, we will go first on the verifying hierarchy report. To view hierarchy report, click on hierarchy report on the site navigation. In this page, UKKPU will be able to see all hierarchy report that have been submitted. To verify hierarchy report, user need to click on under review tab. This will show all hierarchy report that need to be verified. By clicking on one of the report, it will show the detail of the report. Then, on top right of there have a button for UKKPU to verify the report. Click on the button and the pop-up will be shown. There are three report status that can be selected by UKKPU, which is complete, where the report can be viewed by other user. The next status is under review, which means the hierarchy report is still under review by UKKPU. And the last status is revision. Revision means the hierarchy report will be resent to the reporter to update the report based on what UKKPU comment or suggest. For this demo, I will select revision first. UKKPU will enter the reason why this report need to be revision. Then click update. The report will successfully send back to the reporter. To continue the flow of the report, we will log in to OSH representative account. After log in to OSH representative account, we will redirect to OSH representative dashboard. Now, we go to hierarchy report list to see the report that need to be revision. By clicking on the revision tab, we will see the report that need to be revision. By clicking on the report, it will show the detail of the report and the comment from the UKKPU. By clicking on the update button on the top of the report detail, it will allow user to update the report. After complete update the report will be verified back by the UKKPU. In this report, this page also contains other report that has been verified by UKPU under all tab. And lastly, this page also contains current user own report under my report tab. In this web application, OSH representative also can fill in hierarchy form same as in mobile app. Now we go to OSH representative dashboard. In the dashboard, there are several statistics are shown. The statistics that shown are hierarchy report status. This shows total report based on report status for the current user. The next statistic is hierarchy report risk level. And last statistic is hierarchy hazard category, which means it show category on hazard that has been reported. Now we go to PTJ dashboard. To go to the PTJ dashboard, we need to log in user with the PTJ role. In PTJ dashboard, they have some statistics that related to their school. The first statistic show the total higher ed report by its status. The next statistic is higher ed report risk level, and the last statistic is higher ed hazard category, which means that hazard category that have been reported. PTJ also can view higher ed report list. To see higher ed report list, user need to click on higher ed report on the left side navigation. In there, all report that has been verified by UKKPU are shown. In there also, PTJ can see higher ed report based on your school. PTJ also can see higher ed report detail by clicking on the report. After that, it will show the detail of the report. Now we go back to UKKPU dashboard. As we can see under higher ed report list, there are several labels under each of the report. These are the tagging that has been generated by the system by using RAID algorithm. By clicking on the tagging, it will show the record that related to the tagging. It also shows some statistics regarding this tagging. For example, when we click on the School of Health Sciences, it will display the report that has been tagging with School of Health Science. This tagging also can be viewed by the PTJ and OSH representative. This will help them finding related report easily. In this web application, UKKPU also can submit the higher ed report. For UKKPU higher ed form is same as OSH representative higher ed form. As I said earlier, in the UKKPU dashboard, there are several statistics that are related to higher ed report. The first statistic is total higher ed report based on their status. The next statistic is higher ed risk level. This shows how many reports for each risk level. The next statistic is total higher ed report for each area of responsibility. This statistic will show top higher ed report based on the area of responsibility. The last chart is higher ed report keyword frequency chart. This chart shows which keyword has higher frequency in the report. When clicking on the keyword, it will display higher ed report that related to the keyword. In this web application, UKKPU also can manage user. UKKPU can control the user which user can access the web apps and mobile app. So that's all for demo today. As for future work, we aim to make this platform in operation with the permission of Higher University Management.